Hello guys, welcome to Monsters and Monocles. This is a pixelated twin stick shooter, much in the vein of Enter the Gungeon, Nuclear Throne and Dungeon Souls, so if you like stuff like that, you'll probably enjoy this one. This is a early access preview build. This game will hit early access on August 16, that's 4 days from now, and they have this changelog here where you can see what they've done recently in updates. There's also online support. You can play up to 4 players. But let's start a game, check it out. Now you can play with the controller or the keyboard. I started out with the controller, but I couldn't really hit the small stuff, so I changed over to mouse and keyboard. So here you can select 4 players to join, but I'm playing with myself. That didn't come out right. You can choose 4 different characters. This little robot thing looks like an escape from Borderlands. Baron von Dogface, Lady Cannonhail, or Rupert Killingsworth. Let's go with the lovely lady. It's a short intro here. We'll just watch that. So we aboard this airship here, and you can actually kill these chairs. And sometimes they drop gold, but they didn't this time around. A little science here, which is basically the tutorial. There's not much else than that. We can look at the keyboard controls over here. Very basic. WASD move, left mouse button fire. QE to swap weapons, right mouse button dash and space to interact. So there's not much there. We have 3 levels open to us, the mansion, the tomb, and the city. So let's go to the mansion. And here we are in the dungeon. And now we shoot stuff. And there's lots of stuff to shoot. I think this sort of balanced it towards more than one player. This one shoots a little bubblegum net. It also creates little eyes. A lot of the monsters in this game create little... spawns little monsters. So it takes quite a while to shoot all of this stuff that comes at you. And so, oh, let's get out of here. They hit us. Yeah, you can see our health up there. We need to dodge out of the way there. This one teleports, the blue one. The biggest danger in this game is getting surrounded by the monsters because there's so many. And they always spawn little stuff that comes at you as well. And your gun can overheat, not the starter gun that I'm using right now. But when we pick up a better one, we have to watch for it to overheat. And the dodge has a 3-second cooldown, and you dodge in the direction that you're moving, not in the direction you're aiming with the little crosshair. So you have to keep that in mind. I've dodged into a lot of walls, because I didn't know that in the beginning. And we have a number of lives. We can see that we have 2, and that's a life pool. It applies to all of the players that share it. So we're only 1 player now, so we have 2 lives left. So yeah, it can take a while to shoot all these little guys to get past them. He actually hit me there. So just show you a dodge. We'll dodge down here. And it also makes you invulnerable. And it's also a way to move about the level a little bit faster. There's no map. They teleport like little... see there, I'm getting... I can't run into the left there. I'll get surrounded by all of those guys. You have died. Damn it. So this respawns. So that sort of blows up the monsters around you. But that just happened. They're getting surrounded, and that's the biggest danger. We are invulnerable when we dodge, but we can't dodge through stuff. And I don't think we can dodge through the monsters either, so it doesn't really help you if you have been surrounded already. And we haven't found a better gun than the starter gun, so this run is not going too well. There's stuff in here. We found dash more often. Some rogue feather. That guy just keeps shooting a little bubblegum stuff at us to catch us. And here's a cup of coffee. Actually, I think it's tea. And that'll give us back some health. And what is this? I can't see it. Remove the screen there. Mercury's Blessing. Speed up. Okay, so that's very good. So now we're faster. Yeah, speed seems to be what saves you most of the time, rather than the dodge. Let's get this revolver. Or maybe I'm just bad at the game, I don't know. It looks like what we were using before. I think we started with a revolver, so it didn't really help us. So these little guys, the skulls, they start glowing and then they charge you. And we have to vanquish 63 foes. That's our mission for this level. And when we do that, the door will open so we can enter the next level. But before we get to the next level, there will be a shop where we can spend the gold that we pick up. And the mission will vary from level to level. I've had all other levels where I needed to find a key gun and shoot the barrier. And another one, I think, where I just had to find the exit. And eventually we'll get to the boss in the mansion. He's called Skullfumper, maybe? I can't remember. Something with skull. Hopefully we'll get to him in this run. So you can take a look at him. He proceeded to eat my face pretty quickly when I got there. He shoots laser beams that you have to dodge around and use that invulnerability that you have while you dodge. And then he would send little skulls to come at you. These things blow up. Dodge. I didn't dodge in time, we got hit. So it says one life, but we actually have two, because if it gets to zero, we are still alive. Need to hit this little thing coming at us. Yeah, so they exploded a chain there. Here's something. A blunderbuss, let's pick up that. That's, well, very short range, really. It's better than the starter gun. So it's already looking up for us. What the hell? It teleports in. This little ghost, it teleports, and I also think it sort of freezes you to take down your speed a notch. It teleported behind us in the door there. Fuck that. Just died. It's going badly. We're already down to our last life here. It's not going well for the little lady in the dungeon. There's a tricky ghost teleported right behind us in the doorway. Couldn't get out of there. So yeah, the biggest problem is getting surrounded. And it was pretty much happened again there. And we died. Let's head down here. I have to start dodging a little bit more. Game over. I will do another run. So let's do another run, and this time we'll do Rupert to try something else. And skip the intro. Shoot the chairs. No gold. And so far what I know about these levels is that if you beat the mansion and you go back to it, then the difficulty will increase. And then there's a tomb we have open in the city, and the difficulty, I think, also increases in the tomb and the city as opposed to the mansion. In the mansion, a lot of the monsters just runs at you, but at the tomb they start shooting a lot. So we'll go to the tomb, we'll probably die horribly, but we'll do it anyway, just so you can see it. And we'll go to the city after this run. Vanquish 83 foes, so if you play it safe, you might make it to the next level. And there's something called a Dark Pharaoh, I think. And it shoots a lot of bullets, so it's much more bullet hellish in here. There are more monsters that can shoot than there are in the mansion. I think we're fairly safe just standing there, yeah. And there's something else than the starter gun right here, hand cannon. So that packs more of a punch. So I'd like to find a grenade launcher. That's my favorite weapon in the game so far. It's much easier to hit with and to kill a lot of monsters that are bunched together. It charges the little bad guy. Get all of these gold coins. Move up here. These are crabs hiding in the vases, so we can't shoot the vases. We have to make the crabs move before we can shoot them. Like so. When they start moving, we can do damage. And they'll start coming at us at some point. They're fairly easy to kill, so let's just get some kills in on those. They count as well. So there's a chest up there, and there's also a cup of tea. So it'll give us some health back. Grab the tea. The scorpion shoots. And there's an exploding rat. Grab all of these coins, and we'll just see what's in the chest here. So we got a blunderbuss. I think that's better. Let's grab that. And we have something here at a knockback reduction. Grab that. And Ankh of Isis. Grab that. Resurrect on death. Consumes item on use. That's good. Have to be careful not to get hit by the scorpions. Yeah, I'm not dodging quite as much as I probably should because I find it a little bit hard to use it. Because you have to dodge in the direction you're moving, not the direction you're shooting. So here's extra health, I think. And coin range, that's good. 45 foes to go before we can find the exit here. Dodge away when the scorpion shoots. There we go. And that's another blunderbuss, but that's what we already have. And an exploding rat. Let's get some rats. They count towards our score. All of the levels are randomly generated, so it's very different how difficult it is. This one's been fairly easy so far. I'm just gonna get the hand cannon again. Radius plus grenade launcher. So we get I think we can shoot. But we don't have a grenade launcher, so it's not that helpful, I guess. We need some dodge out of that. There's little mummies, and I think they've got some bandages open to the brain. And more health. A cup of tea. Just 11 foes to go. Dodge away from this. Yes, so the cooldown is 3 seconds on the dodge. So you can't spam it. And if you have the automatic weapons, they can overheat as well if you keep shooting. Here's another weapon, spread shot, let's get that. Just 3 foes. There's one left. I think that's it. So now we need to find the exit. And there's a little icon up here pointing towards it. We have extra range, so we can hit these guys off screen. That guy's just annoying. Maybe we can go around him. The spread shot doesn't do that much single target damage unless we hit with all of them. Alright, so we get in there when he's not shooting. There we go. But yeah, we made it to the shop. So now we get to take a look at that. And it's basically just a bunch of tables where you can pick up a gun, health, or an item. Gun oil. Machine gun. It costs 1000 gold, we can't afford it. Doesn't look like we can afford a weapon. We can get the extra health, but that's not really that helpful. There's also a chest here. Burn effect on stake launcher. I don't think we have one. And there's also gun oil, so we get that. Fire rate up, overheat faster. It's a T-gun. What the hell is that? It looks like it's probably better than what we have. Let's just use that and we'll head out. Lost tomb level 3. Proceed to the exit and make one's getaway. So here we just find the exit, I guess. So the T-gun just overheated. So it takes a while before we can use it again. It takes a long while before we can use it again. What the hell? It's just continually red. Alright, that's it. I'm switching back to the spreadshot. Fuck the T-gun. That's more like it. It takes a lot more time before this overheats. But now it's turning red, so we just have to wait a little bit. And some health, that's good. I dodged in the wrong direction. If you dodge into anything, it ends the dodge immediately. Also, if you dodge into the monsters. Almost dead here. That's the exit. So now we made it to the boss. Objective vanquished Tutankhamun. So he's probably going to do something crazy. He's just shooting at us. We're not really damaging him at all. But now we are. Well, we have to shoot him from the front. Yeah, we can't hit him unless we hit the front. Just dodge over here. Need to be closer to hit. So I think the spread gun is pretty good against this guy, maybe. So you can hit him from an angle. Without like, we actually need to be closer. And we're not doing very much damage to him. It's going to take forever. And he'll probably start doing something else later on. Is he just gonna do this all of the time? So now he's starting up something else here. A little flower. The gun overheated. And he jumps away. And there's another flower. I have to dodge through it maybe. Ah, we can just stay far away. Maybe we can get past here now, get some hits in. I died there, just got tapped by one of the balls. Just wait it out, the gun's overheated. Doesn't look like we can damage him right now, but now we can. So we almost have him. Just have to be careful here. Damage up, recoil up. Found some item over there in the corner. Got hit there a little bit. Okay, we have to stay in front of him, get some damage in. I just died again, damn it. So now we're down to the last life. Alright, so we're not taking any chances here. I'm almost dead here. There we go, finally. So he dropped a lot of coins. Another anchor thesis, resurrect on death, consumes one use. And flamethrower, let's grab that. Just grab this coin here and then we'll head through the door. Jolly good show, press A to continue. So now we're back here. And as far as I know, we can't do anything here really. We can head up to the airship controls, but that doesn't do anything. And there's no inventory either yet, where we can check anything that we have. And we can see that we completed the tomb one time. Alright guys, we'll leave off here. I think that the game still needs some development and some features like inventory and perhaps a bomb that you can use. So you'll have a different weapon in a sticky situation and make the gameplay more dynamic. But it's still early in development. The game will hit Steam Early Access in 4 days. And I think that that will help the developers to get feedback from the players and which direction to take the game. But I think the core gameplay and the pixelated art is pretty good so far. So keep an eye on this game if you think it looks interesting. I'll put the link in the description. Thank you for watching and I'll catch you all next time.